This is Car Guys New England, and this video topic is about just some of the maintenance that you have to do when you're running countermeasures in your vehicles. And I'm referring to the stuff I have in the Lamborghini and also my daily driver as well, because I do a lot of business travel in my daily driver, so it pretty much has all the same countermeasures that I have in the Lamborghini. So, this video is about updating the parking sensors in the vehicles for the latest threats that are out there, and also updating the radar detectors to the latest GPS-based information that's out there on each state. And then there are other things that need to be updated as well, like, for example, periodically I like to check the scanners to make sure that all the frequencies are still valid on them and everything like that. But anyways, here's a clip to check out.
All right, let's update this. And pretty straightforward, but it's about time that I update the anti-laser priority in here. So, but that's pretty much it. It'll just take a few minutes and we'll be good to go. And also updated the Town Cars ALP system as well. So we are 100% up to date.
So what you just saw there was a USB-based update for anti-laser priority. And that was an update of the firmware, the voice pack, and also my options that I have set up in there that I happen to like.
All right, let's give this a quick test.
ProLaser 3, ahead.
Yeah, I'd say that works.
So the video that you just saw, I was using a handheld testing remote. And the reason I was doing that was just making sure that none of the settings had changed with the ALP system. That's not really a good way to effectively test your anti-laser priority or any other parking sensors that you may happen to set up. So just something to be aware of. There are people that you can get your systems tested through, and I highly recommend that, because you'll actually be able to find weaknesses in your defenses, and to see if you get punched through with certain LiDAR guns. So that's something that you're going to want to get checked out by a professional. And but again, like I said, that particular video clip was solely just for the fact that I just wanted to make sure that certain settings were carried over when I updated the firmware, the voice pack, and as well as the settings. So just keep that in mind. So I'm going to have to take this Max 360 down and bring that into the house, as well as the radar detector in my other vehicle. And we'll get both of these out, get them updated, and get them back in the vehicles. One thing to note is Escort updates their radar detectors, or puts out updates for the radar detectors weekly on the Defender database. And that's what we're updating here. They're GPS based, and they update different states. Since I kind of am all over the place, it's a wise idea just to continue to update things on a weekly basis.
All right, so let's take this radar detector out. Let's unhook the power and take this down. And there we go. And now we got to get the other one out. All right, and we're going to take this one out. Actually, I need both hands, so just stand by and we'll get this one out in a minute. All right, and we got this one out. I did a custom carbon fiber wrap on it just to, make it kind of go with the car. I just thought it was cool. Normally on a car like this, you'd actually probably want to do a installed radar detector versus a
you know, a dashboard mount one, but I happen to, you know, really like the Max 360. You know, the kind of mixed reviews out on them out there, but I really got nothing bad to say about them other than some issues that I had with the one in my daily driver. But this one's been pretty reliable. It is tough to hear in this car, though. But anyways, let's get both of these radar detectors updated, and then we'll get them back in the vehicles.
All right, so the next step that we have here is we hooked up the radar detector with a USB to the computer, and we're just going to run the update. So we are going to update the radar detector with the latest updates. And you know, we just have to wait for this to finish, and then we'll be all set.
Anyways, that's a wrap on today's video. So hopefully you get a feel for some of the maintenance that's required to keep your countermeasures up to date. That's how I keep my fleet of vehicles up to date. But anyways, thank you very much for watching. If you're not subscribing, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We're going to continue to put out lots of new content. And also be sure to give it a like if you like the video, and leave your comments and questions down below. Anyways, this is Car Guys New England. Until then, take care.